Kia ora katoa. Fantastic. Kia ora katoa, my name is Andon Angelo. I work in the South Island of New Zealand at Canterbury University. We're a mid-sized, mid-ranked university, but we punch above our weight with our repository, according to the Spanish repository service. I'm very proud of that. What I want to talk to you about is a good enough publishing, academic publishing system. So, institutional repository is Swiss Army knife. And like a Swiss Army knife, repositories are pretty much the worst tool for every job. Yeah? But they do everything. And so I want to show you what we've been up to. So, the first thing I want to talk about is what a journal is made of, and how a publishing system works. You know all this. There's a website, there are files that are part of that website, there's an editorial board that we know and love, and there are some authors who provide, talk to the ed board, create files, got a website, bingo, we have a journal. This is a really straightforward, simple process that happens. We know that the authors provide material to the ed board that then gets sent for review and back. We know that this can go around a few times in terms of review once something's accepted. The authors then produce files, might not be typeset, some other bits and pieces, and they get put on the website. Apart from when there's a problem with that, they have to get taken down, and then the authors have to provide the files. Yeah. This isn't a straightforward process at all. It's terrifying. Yeah. So this, I think, is what stops a lot of librarians from approaching publishing and doing publishing as an activity. Is they look at this and think, this is just too hard. I have seen exactly parts of this process myself. I was an editorial, a technical editor for a small social sciences journal for a while, and I saw a lot of the interestingness that goes on as part of this process. So my idea was to take out what libraries can do, think about this kind of strategically, and then apply this to creating our own publishing system. So here is the way that I approach most things. 20% of your time and effort, if you think about it, can produce 80% of the results. Okay. So this is why I talk about good enough. This is my reason behind it. And I like to call that my license to be lazy. We have no money at Canterbury. We had a big earthquake 5 years ago. We're still spending insurance on that. We had half the number of students come the next year. It was one of the biggest earthquakes in an urban region in the world. You can imagine, international students in particular are a little put off. Combine that with some demographic issues. We have no money. So everything we have to do has to be good thinking rather than spending money on something. So, the lightweight publishing model. What I did is I completely blank boxed the editorial process. That process that we saw before, I don't care. It happens. I get given files. I make that very explicit with my editorial boards. The institutional repository is a bucket, but it's a particularly special bucket because it talks to a whole lot of different things, like Google Scholar particularly well, and some other, when we were talking about data mining, I had some other ideas about how we can improve this. It also talks to our National Library and a thing called New Zealand Research, which is a repository aggregator, which gets aggregated in turn. The National Library are even thinking about this process as being sufficient for legal deposit. And then I let the editorial board create their own website. I give the editorial board DOIs. Hey, bingo, we have a journal. There's some risk involved with that, and the risk is dealt with through a memorandum of understanding with the editorial boards. They say things like, I expect you to behave to the standards of the Open Access Scholarly Publishing Association, which have a code of conduct which is fantastic. Because it comes from somewhere else, there isn't any bickering about it, and it is really good. I expect your journal, if appropriate, to be put into the directory of open access journals. Okay, so what do you get? You get DOIs or handles for your articles. You get legal deposit, we'll talk about that. You get good presentation of your metadata so things are findable. When I talk about preservation, I have a formal preservation policy. If this was just a journal on a website somewhere in our university, there is no preservation policy, in fact, quite the opposite. So these are the things that I can do well. This is the 20% of work that I can do to give value into. What you don't get is a website. I used to be a web developer. I'd never want to do that again. And I especially don't want to work with small groups that are doing it. So they do it themselves. Sometimes their nephews can build a website for them. So automated review, we don't give them that, which is a nice thing to have, we can't. And they don't get big publisher support in terms of things like layout. So all those things that big publishers can do for you. But I'll show you that that's not such a bad thing. Here's the most prominent of the journals that we're running at the moment. It's called Continental Football Theory. And you're thinking, that's DSpace, that's ugly. And you're right, because DSpace is the prettiest thing in the world. But no one wants to see something on DSpace. It doesn't give you volume numbers, it doesn't give you issue numbers. It gives you the abstract, but it's pretty ugly. That's why I make them create their own website. The editors for this website think that this is beautiful. It's not finished. This is actually becoming, in its third iteration, it is becoming a foremost journal in this particular space. Here is the layout from a particular another journal. It's beautiful. I was concerned about layout. The articles will look like rubbish, and they don't. Also notice the CC BY at the bottom. And what are we doing next? Going to DOIs, I lied, we haven't quite implemented DOIs yet. Integration, hopefully, with our university press, and just hand them a digital publishing arm. And also better analytics is something else I want to provide. So for a journal that's, say, run by students, an emerging journal, it's a fantastic incubator. If they then want to go on and use Scholastica or go to a big publisher, I'm perfectly happy to. In fact, I'm encouraging them to. This is not about being precious. So thank you very much. I'll just run the credits because they were CC BY. Thank you.
So I'm not a very good chair. I forgot to mention we'll take questions at the end. So.